I'm going to show you how to create, access, and manipulate dictionaries like a pro. A dictionary in Python is a collection of key value pairs. And what that means is each item in a dictionary has a unique key and a corresponding value associated with the key. And the keys themselves in a dictionary can be any type, but they must be unique. Whereas the values in a dictionary can also be any type, but they can be duplicated. Now, creating dictionaries in Python is super easy. To create a dictionary, you simply enclose a comma-separated list of key value pairs in curly braces and assign it to a variable. If you want to see the output, you can add some print statements to the code, and that would output our dictionary to the console. Now, one of the most common operations you'll need to perform with dictionaries is adding and removing items. So to add a new key value pair to the dictionary, you can use the update method. So for example, you can add a new key value pair to my dict, where the key is favorite color and value is blue. Now to remove an item from a dictionary, you can use the del keyword and provide the key of the item you want to remove. So let's remove the age item from my dict. Another common operation you might need to perform with dictionaries is checking whether a particular key exists in the dictionary. To do this, that's the in keyword, and that returns true if the key exists in the dictionary and false if it doesn't. To see the output of this code, we'd need to add a print statement to print out the value of the name exists variable. And as the name does exist, it gives us a value of true. Okay, so that's some of the mechanics, but why would you want to use dictionaries in your own Python projects? Well, let's take a look at an example using a shopping cart. So first, let's create a dictionary to represent our shopping cart. And each key in the dictionary will be the name of an item, and the corresponding value will be the quantity of that item in the cart. Now that we've added some items to the cart, let's see what's inside by printing the contents of the dictionary. And that outputs this. Now, the dictionary contains the items we added along with the corresponding quantities. So let's use the dictionary to calculate the cost of the items in the cart. Now, we're defining the prices in the code here for convenience. When we add apples, oranges, and bananas, then calculate the cost, we get a total cost of the items in the cart. One of the most powerful features of dictionaries is the ability to nest them inside each other. This allows you to create complex data structures that can be easily accessed and manipulated. The data dictionary here contains two keys, that's user 1 and user 2, which are themselves dictionaries containing information about the users. We can use this information using the usual dictionary syntax. Now let's print that out, and here's what we get. Another useful feature of dictionaries is the ability to use them as counters. This allows you to easily keep track of, for example, how many times a particular value appears in the dataset. The counter dictionary contains the words of each word in the words list. That gives us 3 hellos, 2 worlds, and 1 Python. Now, sets are a special type in Python that represent a collection of unique elements. And dictionaries can be used as sets because they only allow one entry for each key. This means that if you try to add the same key to a dictionary more than once, the second and subsequent entries will be ignored. And then looking at the output of this dictionary, we can see it only contains the unique numbers from the numbers list. And that's because when we added the numbers to the dictionary, the second and then the subsequent occurrences of each number were ignored due to the fact that dictionaries only allow one entry for each key. Another useful feature of dictionaries is the ability to use them as switches in conditional statements. And this allows you to easily check whether a particular value is present in a dictionary and perform different actions based on that value. So here we're using the in operator to check whether a particular value is present in the dictionary, and then using the value to perform different actions in the code. Red, yellow, and green are in the dictionary. Pink is not. And that's dictionaries. It's one of many powerful features in Python. Speaking of which, Python can do some clever things with arrays, and to learn about those, watch this video.